Good morning, you guys. Happy Friday. I was absolutely not planning to do an Instagram Live, and I may very much regret the fact that I'm doing an Instagram Live without putting it on a camcorder, tripod, because I'm holding this with my left hand, and if I go any longer than a few minutes, I'm gonna regret this. And of course, the second I start my Instagram Live, my client, who was supposed to call me at 8 o'clock, decides to text me and say, I'm ready. Anyway, here's what I wanted to share with you guys. And we'll just keep switching arms. I have really had this lesson hit home with me. And this can apply again, kind of like my Instagram Live yesterday. It can apply to both fitness, but for those of you who are entrepreneurs or bloggers or influencers or, you know, earning income, hustling your ass off in any way, my biggest encouragement to you is to really think about this. Stop trying to back end what you want to accomplish. I have been hitting some major realizations about myself. Hey everybody, Tracy, how are you? I've really been hitting these aha moments about myself and my productivity, and the fact that I find myself continually frustrated that, you know, for example, if in a typical day I want to get a run in the morning, and then I want to get my lifting session in the afternoon, and I say I'm going to get my lifting sessions in, got to be starting by 2 p.m. because I just know myself, I don't have the same energy to put into a strong lifting workout session after 2 o'clock. Once it gets to be 3, 4, 5 o'clock, I just don't have as much in me as I used to. That has to do with hormones, it has to do with age, it has to do with personal preference. And I found myself, you know, saying I'm gonna work out at 2, and then I push everything back, I get work stuff happening, and I'm trying to back end and fit it in on the back end. Same thing, you guys have heard me talk about this with my nutrition. When I don't plan out my macros in advance and I don't say, okay, like for example, tonight, we always do date night on Friday nights. We always drink alcohol on Friday nights. We don't drink it during the week, and I try to limit alcohol to 1, maybe 2 nights a week max, Friday, Saturday. So if I know I'm gonna drink alcohol tonight, I've gotta plan what I'm gonna eat today. And then also plan, you know, what restaurant are we gonna go to? What can I order there? Typically, if we know we're gonna enjoy alcohol, we won't typically get dessert. And quite honestly, a lot of times we'll order like a fantastic steak or fish dinner. But if I haven't planned that, and then I front load and eat too much during the day, and I haven't anticipated and planned ahead, then I'm gonna get to the restaurant and look at my macros and go, well, shit. You know, I've got like 300 calories. How many of you have done that? Where you don't track, and then you're getting ready to go out, and you should be allowing Clueline. For those of you that don't know, if you're going to a restaurant and you want to order whatever you want, you should assume you're going to spend at least 1,500 calories. If you're good, you can watch it and maybe spend, you know, if there's a glass of wine in there and anything with any kind of fat and calories and butter, and that's pretty much every restaurant item in the world, you need to allow for 800 to 1,000 calories, period. So if you haven't planned your day accordingly by either practicing intermittent fasting or really eating light, then you're going to get to your dinner and go, okay, I'm either gonna blow it and be way over on my calories, or I'm gonna have to not enjoy myself. So when you back end things, and what I'm saying by back ending is waiting until the end of whatever it is, the day, your work day, whatever, and trying to squeeze in all of your results kind of retroactively, it's never gonna work. And if you are like me, by the way, waving back to all of you, if you're like me, it will be so much more helpful for you. This is such a simple concept, but it's lost on so many of us, myself included. I have been really struggling with productivity in my work life, and I've also been struggling fitting in my workouts when I want to do them. And what I mean by that is I have made the commitment that I'm doing this 12-week challenge within the Transform app, and I really want to do all my workouts at the gym. in order for me to do my workouts at the gym where I can really lift heavy and really kick ass, more so than I can working out from home. You guys all know how that works. You can train heavier at the gym because you have machines and you have trainers and so on and so forth. I wanna go when it's not peak hours, when it's not 6 o'clock at night, when every schmo in the universe, every 25-year-old guy is sitting on every machine texting his girlfriend or taking Instagram photos of himself. I don't wanna go when it's that crowded. So I really have to plan ahead. If I don't plan ahead, what's been happening a lot this week is I tell myself, I'm gonna work out at 2. And then I allow my day to get ahead of me. And because I didn't schedule it, then it, all of a sudden I'm looking up, it's 3:30, 4 o'clock, and I'm like, holy hell, where did the day go? I'm not able to back end that workout in at the gym, because if it's 4 or 5 o'clock, I'm either gonna go to the gym when it's crowded and hate my workout, or I'm gonna work out at home and be disappointed because I'm not gonna be able to get as much of what I wanted and use the machines that I wanted because I'm back-ending it. If you do the same, I've already used the reference of nutrition. If you don't plan ahead, then you can't fix it at the end of the day. You can't undo what you've eaten. Why not plan ahead? And here's the thing, for those of you who are maybe just getting started on a weight loss journey, for those of you who have never been able to lose weight or whatever, and you think that the only way to lose weight is to have plain chicken and steamed broccoli and eat it 6 times a day out of Tupperware and you have to work out 2 hours a day at the gym, that's baloney. There certainly are people years ago that did that. They kind of call that bro science. That's not necessary. You can absolutely have the kind of foods you enjoy. You don't have to cut out everything. You don't have to go keto. You don't have to do intermittent fasting. You don't have to go paleo. You don't have to go vegan. You don't even have to eat perfectly clean and non-GMO and organic to lose weight, period. You have to have a caloric deficit. I'm not a trainer or a nutritionist or a doctor or a dietitian. I just hang around enough of them and I've interviewed quite a lot of them on my podcast. And I encourage you guys to go listen to the podcast. I'll link it up after I post this on YouTube. But it really is about planning ahead and trying to have some kind of balance of getting a good amount of protein in, getting some healthy fats in, and watching your carbs. It doesn't mean don't have bread forever. It doesn't mean don't have cereal forever. It doesn't mean you can't have alcohol or sugar. It's all about balance and planning it out. But again, to what I said at the beginning of the show, you can't back end your day. You can't back end your nutrition. You can't back end what you want to do in your work day at 4 o'clock, you know? So learn your lesson, learn this lesson with me, and realize if you want to make changes in your productivity at work, in your diet, in your body, we're talking about fitness, we're talking about productivity at work. Really, those would be the two primary areas. In your food, in your working out, in your training, in your productivity, or whatever it is at the office. Whatever you're doing now, can we all agree, like, if you're frustrated, it's not working, right? So do yourself a favor, take some time to go, okay, what would really work for me? You know what too many people do? It's like I talked about yesterday. They give themselves excuses to not start. Too many people will go, well, you know, I've tried to work out in the morning. It doesn't work out for me. I just can't get up that early. Well, why don't you just take 10 minutes of your day today and go, what's ideal for me? It took me a while to realize, like, I suck at working out at night. So if I know I suck at working out at night, how can I figure out a way that's doable where I can get my workout in? And it also fits with my productivity goals. I know that I'm most productive from the time I get up in the morning, whether that's 5 a.m. or 8 a.m. I'm most productive in the morning until about 2 or 3. Can I still work late and get stuff done? 4, 5, 6, 7? Yes. Workouts? Not so much. So I take those two things together and I'm like, okay, I really want to be productive. I really want to get my workouts in by 2. It's not going to work for me to plan my workouts at night. So how do I schedule my workouts during the day, but still take advantage of the fact that I'm best and I'm most productive for work early in the morning? I'm going to start getting up 1 hour earlier. It's not going to be pretty the first week, but I'm going to start getting up at 5 instead of 6 because I want to have that maximum amount of time, then be able to go do my workout by 2 o'clock in the afternoon. And if I want to, then I want to be done for the day. And if I want to come back and get some of my continuing education, I'm doing a lot of continuing education right now, then I can do that, which doesn't require a lot of energy, just me sitting and listening to these video trainings online. I can do that, but you see, you've got to take the time to figure out what works best for you. Some of you might do great working out at night, and you might sit there and go, well, all this time, if you want to watch The Bachelor or The Bachelorette, or you want to watch Grey's Anatomy at night, and you still want to be able to fit in a workout, why can't you watch that on your phone or on your tablet, or you know, if you've got a treadmill at home, do your workout in front of the TV. Combine the best of both worlds. But the bottom line is, don't wait till you get home and you're tired and exhausted and sit down in front of Grey's Anatomy and then go, oh, I really need to work out, but I'm gonna watch this show until 10 o'clock and then bitch and moan that I didn't work out and go to bed pissed off. Don't back end your day. That's my biggest piece of advice to you. It's the biggest thing I'm learning. Save yourself the stress and frustration of disappointing yourself every day, whether it's with your eating, with your training, or with your work stuff. You deserve to take the time to really think about this. It's not gonna take that long, but too many people miss this step. They just keep getting frustrated over and over and over again, and they never take the time to go, okay, there's a better way. There's a better way. They don't take the time to go, okay, why is it that I'm procrastinating? What is it that I'm doing wrong that's making me feel so behind the eight ball? I've been this way for 5 or 6 years, really ever since I became an entrepreneur. I have not been good at time management. I have not been good at being proactive versus being reactive in my schedule. And it wasn't until just this year, really, that I took time to go, you know what? I can design my day. I can figure out what my best day looks like so that I'm at my best. Let's see what the General Rebel says. I'm most successful when I write it down on a dry erase calendar board and I have it scheduled off for the week. That's a great, and yes, you can TBR your shows. That's absolutely right. Who wants to watch commercials anyway? Truthfully though, I don't claim that what I'm sharing with you is rocket science. It's not like it's some, you know, overly complex thing, but the bottom line, sometimes it's the simplest things. I wrote a blog post, maybe it was yesterday. It was sometime this week. So go over to kellyolexa.com and you can see there's a personal blog and a business blog. But I was talking about how so many of us, and this can be in our fitness journey, it can also just be in life, we're on autopilot, you know? And I remember when I first moved and decided I was gonna move from Chicago to Phoenix, I ended up moving to Austin, Texas. Now I live in San Antonio. When I first decided to move, I sold the vast majority of my stuff. I wanted to start over. I wanted all new furniture, everything. So I sold all of my stuff up in Chicago. Whatever I kept, I put into storage, and I moved to Austin. And I got so many DMs on social media from people going, oh my God, I wish I could do what you were doing. And I'm like, what do you mean? And they're saying, I wish I could live, you know, go live where I want. I've always wanted to live in Florida. I've always wanted to do this. I wish I could be an entrepreneur like you, but I have kids. Or I wish I could get fit like you, but I'm 40 and I work full-time. Do you know how many 40-year-olds that work full-time that have kids are fit? It's just a matter of figuring out what you want and then figuring out what you have to do to get there and then figuring out how do I make that happen? I'm not saying it's easy. I'm not saying it's easy. I'm gonna have to start getting up at 5 if I really wanna maximize my day. I'm also gonna have to start tightening up my schedule, tightening up and planning when I'm gonna be on social media, when I'm gonna give myself that time to just go on Instagram and look at stuff. It's not like, you know, if you wanna be productive, I'll give you 2 examples and I'll close. If you wanna do things differently and you waste a lot of time, I'll give you the productivity example first. It doesn't mean that you have to cut everything out that's fun, cut everything out that you enjoy, okay? That's a recipe for not sticking with it. But for example, if you end up futzing around and wasting a lot of time texting people, this is something for me. I used to get up every morning and send a Bitmoji good morning to all of my friends. And then my list got longer and longer and longer, and I would be spending 20 minutes. Now you might think 20 minutes, is that a big deal? 20 minutes there, plus 20 minutes randomly on Facebook, 20 minutes here on Instagram. You know, that can add up to an hour and a half, 2 hours a day. I can get a lot done in an hour and a half, 2 hours a day when it comes to sales follow-up, getting proposals out, following up with clients, closing contracts, getting invoices paid. That's money on the table. Would you rather give up if somebody said to you, well, I tell you what, I will pay you $5,000 or you can go on Facebook for 2 hours. What would you rather do? I think most people would take $5,000. So start to think about the trade-off. However, if you want to be more productive, it doesn't mean that you have to not go on Facebook. It just means if you realize that going on Facebook, and hello, these apps are designed to make you stay on there a long time. Doesn't mean that's a bad thing. They are designed to make you keep scrolling and never stop scrolling. So have that in mind, set a timer and say, I'm gonna give myself 15 minutes at the beginning of the day. When I first get to work, I'm gonna have my coffee and I'm gonna go on Instagram. 15 minutes when you take your lunch break, you're gonna go on Facebook, you're gonna connect with your mom, you're gonna send emails to your friends, blah, 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 blah. You're gonna read that newsletter that you love. And 10 minutes or 15 minutes before bed, don't take your tablet and your phone to bed with you. That's bad for your health. That's how you do it. You still allow yourself to have the pleasure of doing what, you know, gives you some light, fluffy time, but you're also changing and limiting it so that you have more time for what's important for you. Same thing with food, okay? Like I said before, if you're just starting to lose weight, if you've always tried to lose weight and you've never been able to do it, it doesn't mean you have to go hardcore from doing what you're doing now to never having fast food, never having soda, never having chips, going to the movies and bringing vegetables with you, and eating nothing but chicken and broccoli all day. No, it could be something just as simple as like, hey, if you eat out at lunch every single day, try packing your lunch one day a week. Start with one day a week. Start with replacing one soda with water. It doesn't mean eliminate soda. And some people will go, oh my God, you should eliminate soda. Okay, let's like not go there. Just do something differently and plan ahead. That's it. Planning ahead is such a game changer, but so many of us are on like autopilot. I hate my job, I hate my life, I'm fat, I don't fit in my clothes, this sucks. But they never take the time to go, I could do things differently. What they will take the time to do is tell you why they can't do it. Oh, I can't, you know, I can't go and start my own business. I don't have time. I work late. I have to commute, blah, 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 blah. They'll tell you all the reasons why they can't do it instead of taking the time to figure out why they can. Because those that have done it, that's all they did. They figured out how to do it. And it wasn't easy. Nobody that is really successful in weight loss or in their business is going to go, oh, well, you know what I did is I just cut out half a cup of soda and I lost 25 pounds in a month. And ever since then, it's just been easy. No one ever said that, and no one ever will. That's all I got for you guys. I have work to do. I'm gonna go talk with my client who's still texting me. I hope you guys have a great Friday. Have a great weekend. I hope you take this to heart. Please, please, please take it to heart. It's helping me a lot. It sometimes is a tough thing to learn how much you've held yourself back. However, when you realize that it's just you and that you are in control of fixing that, I think it's such a beautiful thing because you go, hey, if I've been holding myself back and I can change this, think about what's gonna happen in the future when you do. You guys have a great rest of the day. I will see you later. Make sure you head over, if you wanna read some of my most latest brilliant blog posts, head over to kellyolexa.com and subscribe. I'm really starting to blog again and vlog again. I'm really, really loving it. And also have some big announcements coming up next week. So I will see you guys then. Have a great weekend.